What's up, YouTube? Peace. Hotep, the Black Man is God. Today, I'm making a video about the upcoming movie for Blade in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And today, what I really want to talk about is what is going to be the plot of the new Blade movie. And what I think is they should just go ahead and completely reboot, which they are doing. That's why we have a new actor. Mahershala Ali, who's I think is going to do a great job. And I think they should go to the animated series. The anime. I mean, there was a character in there, a female character that was like Blade's sidekick. I don't think that they need that. But as far as his origin, you know, his mother and how Frost bit his mother, and the Frost from the animated series was just on a whole nother level than the Frost from the Wesley Snipes Blade movies. So I liked that Frost, and he was just like way, way more powerful. And yeah, I liked that storyline, and it was kind of similar to the storyline from the Blade movie with the council or the secret Illuminati of vampires. So I really liked that. And another thing I like about the Blade anime is they didn't just have him fighting just vampires. I mean, we went through the Wesley Snipes trilogy, and every movie it was vampires. It's a different variation of vampires, so genetically altered vampires in the later movies, but vampires nonetheless. But in the animated series, Blade fights werewolves, just weird monsters. I mean, he fights demons, there's just so many different things, so many different kind of enemies. I didn't think I'd seen any zombies in the animated series, but there were like these flying falcon, weird monster things that he was fighting, and there was like, it was a lot. And Frost, he was like a scientist. He made genetically altered a lot of different kind of vampire things that the Blade fought. So it was like, I think it was like a six-headed dragon at one point. And then also Blade, he had these different abilities. Like he had the ability to channel his chi energy. And in the, they showed how he got his sword and how he learned his martial arts training. And he like went to Japan and he like trained with like some samurai. And there was this other guy, Kikyo, that he fought with and he trained with, and it was like he was kind of like a Wolverine character. But that was a great animated series. You should watch that, and I really believe that that's where they should draw from for the next Blade movie, especially the part where he's in Japan and he's learning all the, you know, the samurai moves and shit. Like I really like that. And then there's another part where he goes to Madripoor here, and he fights Wolverine. So I think if they could have a Wolverine cameo, I know the whole Spider-Man thing, because Blade usually crosses over with Spider-Man and Morbius, but I know the whole Spider-Man Morbius thing, like they the rights issues with that, but there's no rights issues with Wolverine. And to see like a crossover with Blade and Wolverine in the movie, that would be awesome. That would be totally awesome. We know who the new Blade is, but they haven't revealed who will be the new Wolverine. And I think that would be something that would be good. Because in the animated series, they did have a kind of like a fight. But it wasn't really like a fight. They kind of just clashed for a second. But it was great just to see those two characters. Because not a lot of people know that Blade is a part of Marvel. I mean, more people are going to know now. But yeah, I think that'll be something that is great for the Marvel and the Blade universe. What else happened in the anime? That's pretty much it. Yeah, thanks for listening to the video, and peace. Hotep, the Black Man is God, and I'm out.